Hey, and welcome back to the second episode of the new show called Meal Time. Alright, a week, 1.5 weeks ago, I uploaded this video, actually 2 weeks ago. Okay, it's 2 weeks ago, I uploaded this video, and this was the first episode of Meal Time. For the people that don't know what the show is, you can send your work, your web design project, to me, and I tried to give valuable feedback in this episode. So a lot of people have emailed me also since the first episode, so I have a lot of emails to go through. Like I said before, I want at least 3 emails, but that's not a problem anymore. So we're just gonna dive in really quick and see what kind of cool projects you guys have been making. Okay, so this is an email from Julian. Hey, what's up, Reno? I'm a freelance graphic designer from France. Nice, I watched your last video and I find the concept awesome. Thank you. I share with you my website. It's my first complete site of all time. Wow. Wow. He's sending his first website ever. For the design, I use Elementor Pro and some plugins, Jet Elements, Jet Tricks. I'll be happy to have your overall opinion on the site. Design, UI, UX, navigation. Okay. For the portfolio, for the moment, there are only personal projects and school projects. That's not a problem. That's how we all start, right? Sorry for my English. Also, sorry for my English. It's also not perfect. So let's see what he has made. Okay. Are we gonna translate the website because it's in France? Yes, we are, because France is very hard. I'm gonna translate it into English. All right, there we go. Okay. Oh, it's called WhatsApp Studio. That's pretty cool. WhatsApp Studio graphic designer, print and web. VS. Okay. 14. Is he 14 years old only? Oh, he's also an entrepreneur. Really nice. Let's just scroll first and then talk about... Am I not zoomed out, by the way? Oh, I am zoomed out. Okay. Let's just first scroll to the website and then I will try to give some feedback. Services. From the logo type to the website. Wow, I like the visual style of this. By the way, I'm gonna accept all of your cookies. website, okay. Digital, okay. Portfolio, latest achievements. Hey, this is in Amsterdam. This mock-up. Okay, so he has already done some logo designs, I guess. What is this? Oh, this is probably a school project. This is a logo. This is a logo, flyer, what is this? Print, poker event. Let's just click on a few items and see what happens. Okay, so it's a dynamic website, I think, because there's a /portfolio/ and then a project name. Poker event, France poker tour, details, brief, gallery. Okay, oh nice, so he made some flyers. All right. Well, first of all, if this is your first website, well, then I have good hope for you, because this is pretty, pretty good for your first website. Let's scroll up and go to one of the other pages, for example, website. I want to see what he can do for my website. Okay, showcase site, e-commerce, one page. This is good. Coming soon. Okay. WordPress. Web design. Responsive. That's an Elementor template, by the way. Security and maintenance. Mm-hmm. Process. Okay. Oh, this is. I think I made this with this add-on. Oh, this is pretty cool. How his process is visually. Okay, so this is actually pretty cool. I also need to implement this on my website. Okay, so let's now dive a little bit more into the feedback. Okay, so first of all, super, super, super good job on your first website. It looks good. Most parts look absolutely good. I don't really understand why the text is left aligned on all of the on the pages. Oh, maybe you designed it on a big screen. But you also need to test your website on smaller screens. I am on a 13-inch MacBook. That's not a huge screen, but it's also not the smallest screen available, so check your website on a smaller laptop before you put it live. Otherwise, you just don't know how it looks on other websites. But okay, here's using different colors. The most prominent color is blue on this page. And then if you scroll to the website, this is also blue. And then there are some colors. So he has a color, I guess, for... No, that's not true, because if we click on website, I thought he had one color per service. He has black blocks over here, but then there is red, there is orange, and then there is green. Oh, and then there's light blue. So I think you, with the colors, and especially like with the images like this, I think you didn't make these images. I'm sure for this image, because I know that this is an Elementor template. And also like this, I think this is also a template. I think I saw this before. So this doesn't feel custom, and that's important. I mean, if you want to show your work to other people, it needs to be your work. I mean, you need to show your value. I mean, it's great that you can just build up a page in Elementor and put a text here and put a text there, but if you want to actually sell websites, you need to have your own work inside of your portfolio. And that's, I think, the main issue. And you said it in your email, there's only school projects and some of your own side projects. But what my advice for you would be is focus more on actually creating projects, because right now the website is more impressive than your actual work. And the website is cool. I mean, it looks cool, but it's kind of like you have designed the packaging, but there's really nothing on the inside. And that's what I think you could improve on. But nevertheless, for your first website, it's absolutely awesome. This is much better than my first website. I mean, let's be honest here. It's much better. Okay. Oh, and also, like, show yourself. I think I'm gonna repeat this advice over and over and over, because designers like to just build a cool website and not put their own face on it. But it's so important that you put your own face on it. Like, over here, you say that you are an entrepreneur, right? But are you 14 years old? You are a graphic designer. Like, put a photo of yourself somewhere. Maybe make an about page. Or did I click on the contact page? No. Oh, okay. There's not a photo. By the way, it's visually, it's good. It's good visually. But like, you need to make it more personal. And also with the colors, like, just use a few colors that you repeat in the whole website. Then it will feel less like a template. I cannot, of course, really dive into the website, but this is my overall feedback. So I hope you like the feedback, and let's go on. So go on to the next email. The next email is from Mukesh, and I'm from India. Pretty cool. I've designed a small one-page portfolio in Adobe XD and then executed it in Elementor and added a few animations. Portfolio link. I needed your feedback on the visual and the UX. All right, let's see what he has made. Okay, I am Mukesh, I design logos and patterns. I need a design, look at this button. Okay, that's funny. Let's just first take a look at his Instagram. He also has a WhatsApp, that's pretty cool. I hope his work is on here. Okay, he is pretty young, I think. Okay, so here are his patterns. Well, at least he has chosen something to focus on. So he also made this pattern, I guess, in the background. What is this? Contact about work. Okay, that's not really clear, but let's just move on first. Work. Also, every design in hashtag 887.com. Okay, so he makes patterns. First of all, before I'm gonna move on, it's so cool that you have chosen something to focus on. I think this is one of the things that creative people do not like to do, because we can create so many different things, but focusing is hard, and he has chosen to focus on just one thing, which is patterns. And now he is here showing off his patterns and his logos, by the way. Did he also say logos? Oh yeah, logos and patterns. Okay, so there are logos and there are patterns. That's it. About. Nice. He has a photo. My name is Mukesh. I'm a 2D graphic designer. This is a cool section. I like this. I like this a lot. Contact. Okay. So he wanted feedback on the visual and the UX. Okay. So let's first talk about the experience when you visit this page. Well, the experience is pretty nice because you know what you're gonna get. And this is one of the flaws that that we see over and over and over in web design portfolios or even just design portfolios, that people are not clear what they sell and their portfolio is full of different things. With this guy, it's not like that. He is just creating logos and patterns. That's it, super easy. But what I think is important for the experience of someone who looks at your website is, I mean, everybody understands how you can use logos, right? But with patterns, it's hard to imagine how this pattern is gonna be used. So for the experience of your patterns, what my advice would be is make sure that you show people how the patterns could be used. So for example, on a flyer background or on a website background or on a phone case or whatever it is. But also understand that selling logos and selling patterns is a very, very different business. I mean, it's good that you've chosen something, but it's still two things which are very different. I mean, patterns are, I think, sold a lot on those websites like Envato, where people just need a nice pattern for their background somewhere and they just buy it for a few dollars and they sell it. But for a portfolio website, it's not that I will go on this website and I'll be like, all right, I want to order this pattern. But for a logo, that's possible, right? Because a client can say, well, I want a logo like that. But a pattern, in my experience, it's not something that you just sell on a B2B level, so on a business-to-business level. It's more like what designers use on different websites. So maybe my advice would be to split those two things completely up, so then the experience of each website will be very clear. So maybe create a website for your patterns, which is like, hey, I am Mukesh, I create patterns which you can use on this and this and this and that. Here are my 10 patterns, you can buy them for this amount. I also design logos, but that's a different portfolio, and that's over here. That is what my advice would be, because those things are just so different. Then, that was the experience part. Now for the visual part, it's black and white. I mean, it's cool, it's creative, because it's patterns, right, and logos. And maybe you just want to keep it black and white, and that's, you know, that's cool. But it's not very recognizable, and people will not easily remember it when there are no colors. Right, I mean, it's not that it looks bad, but it's not really a brand. So from a visual perspective, you need to include some branding elements. And maybe if you really don't want to use colors and you really want to stick to black and white, make sure that you have some branding elements that you can repeat in the website. So for example, here's a line. I mean, you can create patterns. So maybe create like a custom line that you can use on all of your titles, right? So then that could be your branding element, but there needs to be something that people can remember apart from your work. So that's from the visual perspective what my advice would be for this website. So yeah, I hope you can use my advice, and if you have updated your portfolio and you want to show it again, please send me another email. All right, okay guys, and if you're still watching now, I want to say something. The way that I make these videos with the lighting and the camera and the setup, this takes a lot of time, and I want to produce more videos because the last video of Mailtime was like 2 weeks ago, and I know there was a Black Friday video, but I want to make more videos. So that means that I will be creating videos without a face cam that I can just record at home with a microphone in front of me. These videos, of course, will always be with camera, but just so you know, I will always start uploading videos without a face cam, just with my microphone, so I can record and produce and share more things about design. So that's a little message for you. All right, I hope you liked this video. If you also want to send your work, of course, you need to go to livingroompixels.com/mailtime, and all the instructions are there. I got enough emails for the next episode, but if you also want feedback, just send your email. The instructions are here. The link is in the description. And then I hope to see you in the next video.